In case you're new to this channel, allow me to introduce myself. My name is Amar and I'm the CEO of a company called PharmaOffer. It's an online marketplace for medicine makers on the one side and suppliers of pharmaceutical ingredients on the other side. When we started our tech platform a couple of years ago, it was a new approach in a traditional business. Especially since 2019, pharmaceutical companies have started to adopt our solution. During our journey, we learned through trial and error what works best. Sure, we did things right, but we also made mistakes and learned a lot about the pharmaceutical industry and how it works. I'll let you know why I don't tell anybody anymore that I work in the pharmaceutical industry later on in the video. But for now, I want to share the 7 most important things I learned from working in the pharmaceutical industry for over 10 years. The first thing I learned is how flexible pharmaceutical companies can be. I used to think that all pharmaceutical companies act slowly and won't adapt easily. To avoid human mistakes and to guarantee the quality and safety of medicines, pharmaceutical companies have lots of complicated procedures. So it isn't strange that companies tend to move slower because of this. During the first couple of months of 2020, however, at the beginning of the COVID-19 pandemic, I was quite surprised to see what companies were capable of when the situation became critical. I saw many companies exploring creative ways to act quickly and serve the medical market and its patients. Flexibility is definitely possible when it's really necessary, I learned. The second thing that I learned is that quality is more important than quantity. And I'm not talking about pharmaceutical products here. In the early days of PharmaOffer, we've tried to reach as many pharma companies as possible. In the first year, we've probably contacted over 20,000 people. I've learned that no matter how much effort you put into an email, it doesn't work if you bulk send it to many people. Even if just a small part of the email that is sent to more than one person, people will immediately feel that it's not personal. It makes sense because when I receive emails myself, I always quickly scan whether it's personally written to me or if I consider it as spam. Making personal emails costs lots of time and effort, but if you want to increase your chance of success, always write a personalized email and send it to just one person. Another thing that I've discovered is that the market is bigger than expected. Everyone knows that there's plenty of pharma companies based in the United States, Switzerland, China, Germany, India. But what I didn't know was how large the pharmaceutical industry is in more undiscovered markets. It was an eye-opener to me how many pharma companies there are based in countries such as Pakistan, Colombia, Egypt. We actually have companies from over 200 different countries on our platform. Before we started, I wouldn't have guessed this figure at all. The fourth thing that I found out is how important it is to have an inspiring company vision. Allow me to clarify what I learned using this example. Most pharmaceutical companies will have an office building in an industrial zone. You'll be working in a specific department such as purchasing or quality control, or in a production area or the warehouse. As you don't typically see the end user every day, it's easy to forget why we are all in this industry. In the end, improving healthcare and taking care of patients is what it is about. It's important to have an inspiring company vision in order to see what the impact of your work actually is. By inspiring, I don't mean some random words that look nice on your website, but something that's really important to you and to everyone within the company. Some higher goal that you really try to accomplish. Proceeding to the fifth thing that I've learned. The pharmaceutical industry is a world of its own, and frankly, it's a small world. When someone is leaving the company, he or she will probably work at another pharmaceutical company. And that's great because those people know the ins and outs and understand how things work within the pharma market. But I do see the benefit of adding someone to your team without formal pharmaceutical industry experience. Those people will have a critical and fresh look on how things are going and, more importantly, they add another level of experience to the team. Keeping it simple is the sixth thing I've learned from working in this industry. Former Dutch football player Johan Cruyff, what a legend, once said, "Playing football is very simple, but playing simple football is the hardest thing there is." To me, this quote is not only about football. keeping it simple can also be applied to running a business. Here's an example of when we were thinking too complicated. In the early days of FarmOffer, we developed a feature dedicated for exclusive distributors. It works like this. When a buyer was from a specific country, the inquiry wouldn't be sent to the supplier, but it was sent to the distributor, responsible for that area. The idea behind it was fine, and from a technical point of view, it worked great, but it was way too complicated, and we actually decided to delete this feature. Nowadays, when we write a new text or develop a new functionality for the website, we always ask ourselves, can we make it more simple? And last but not least, the seventh thing I found out is that our industry has a bad reputation. Maybe you know this guy, Martin Shkreli, not a legend. He founded Turing Pharmaceuticals and bought the manufacturing license of the antiparasitic drug Daraprim and raised its price from $13.50 per pill to $750 per pill, a factor of 56. And this isn't even the most expensive drug. We made a video about the top 10 most expensive drugs in the world. We'll put a link in the description below. It makes me angry, to be honest. I believe that business is not about finding the edge of what is commercially possible, but using your moral compass to add value to the world and still make a fair amount of profit. In the last couple of years, however, I've noticed that because of these types of pharma cowboys, such as Shkreli, the entire pharmaceutical industry has gotten a real reputation problem. Sometimes it feels like you have to defend yourself when you tell people that you're active in the pharmaceutical industry. Most people don't see the difference between the intention of pharma companies. Like I said in the beginning of this video, in daily life I don't introduce myself as someone who is working in the pharmaceutical industry anymore. It's because of this that I always explain what I try to achieve for the benefit of the global population. I explain that my colleagues and I are fighting the global medicine shortages by making the supply side of pharmaceutical ingredients more transparent. And that's also one of the reasons why we created our series of Pharma Explainer videos, to give some insights in the pharmaceutical industry and also to show the inspiring side of this sector. Those were some of the things I've learned from working in the pharmaceutical industry. Is there anything particular that you've noticed or learned in this industry? I'd love to hear your story, so please drop them in the comments below. I hope you like this video, and if you do, please subscribe to our YouTube channel. It will help us to create more videos like this. Enjoy the rest of your day and see you soon.